like another movie.
To our demo. I own Quansa Kennels. We have an organization, we board, train, groom, all that stuff. That's the work. The fun stuff we do is train. There's a wonderful group of people who participate, and they decided to come along today. Poor Shane, you're sitting out there by yourself. Nobody wants to be by you. Okay. My feeling is that too many people train for specialties. If you start out to do competition obedience, that eliminates a lot of other things. If you start out to do competition agility, then you've forgotten the manners. My feeling is that everything should be a balance. So for that reason, we start every dog as if it's going to be a service dog. That means the dogs have to walk on a nice loose leash. Forward. To the right. Of course, Tammy would want to go the other. Halt.
Wait, Carly, wait.
They need to walk on a nice loose leash, any speed and any direction. Forward. Now, if you can, fast. Go ahead and pass if you need to. Normal. Get back in line. Halt.
Wait.
Okay, let's get, Treya, why don't you find a spot? It's kind of life. You got dogs of all different speeds, all different attitudes. Raise them up forward. A service dog has to behave around other dogs, and that means a right turn through the center of that circle. And they better behave themselves and respect personal space. They are not to have their nose all over everybody. Because as a service dog, they are to be appropriate. Just jump right in there. Go ahead and go. Find somebody to visit with. They need to be appropriate when greeting other people. Nice. They maybe need to ride in an elevator with a crowd. Everybody squish into the center. Okay, doors open, head to the outside. They need to be able to walk with another dog, so partner up with somebody and hand off one of the dogs. Okay, head back. Oh, all right. That's okay, Gus. Okay, there you go. They need to be able to work for other handlers. They need to be appropriate in every way. They need to leave things alone when told, blah, blah, blah. Okay, head back for your the owner. Spread them out a little bit. Where's Crystal? There's Chris. Nancy, can you sit over to the side just a little bit? There we go. Just squeeze in there, Petraea. Petraea, why don't you come up here? Uh-oh, time out for bad behavior. Hold on. Oh, sure. It's the people we have trouble training. Those things happen. Responsible dog owners clean up after their dogs. Inga Bear Kindness. boring dogs. They have to be fun as well. Get them crazy.
Go crazy, yeah. Go crazy.
Go okay, crazy. Turn them off. Some of the younger ones haven't learned to come off quite so easily. Okay, at this point, we would begin teaching obedience, agility. So go forward, and you're going to jump over the jumps as you go by. You're just doing the circle. That's all the agility we have right now. Over. That's not even a question. It's like, you got to be kidding. Every command you teach is another tool. Now keep going, honey. Well, no. You can't stop the line. Okay, don't go over the jumps a second time. Just get back on the circle. You can use the tools now that you've taught him and use that to have some fun. Okay, we need to divide up into two teams. Okay, we need six on this team over along the fence and six over here. Oh, back up, you cheaters. Back up. Yep, standing on the first star. Back up, you guys. These darn competition people. They can run twice. Oh, we need one extra person over there. Who wants to go over there? Dennis, you want to go over there? You're the troublemaker. They can keep you in line. Now, many of these dogs do go to dog shows. Some of them show in confirmation. We've got some champions. We've got dogs that herd. We have dogs that do a variety of things. All are good citizenship level right now. Some are way beyond that. Some are actually service dogs. Okay, one of the fun things we do is competition. Now, you'll see them get to be not nice people because these people like competition. So this can be really funny. All right, you're going to sit. I don't care if you sit down, sit, or sit, whatever. We have dogs at all levels. It doesn't matter. Okay. And run, sit, whatever, back. Okay, this is competition, the championship of the world. Okay, on your mark, get set, go. You're talking to Tammy here. Nice. Nice. Now, in making the training fun, it's a lot more fun for the dog, too. What is this? He does it backwards? Good.
You think outside the box.
Yeah, once they get started, you can't tell them anything. They do whatever they do. But you know, the prize isn't all that huge. The prize is actually the behavior. We'll take it any day. Don't hurt yourself, Jaeger. Nice.
Good boy. Good job, Teddy. Good boy.
Now, when you think about the temperaments, these great, these big, tough guard dogs, these dogs are not bred to do these silly things. And yet, doing them, they are. It says a lot about the handling. These people have not just trained dogs. They've become a team with their dog. This is a team. The dog's behavior reflects the lifestyle it lives. Very nice. A good dog works for anybody that takes it, if it's been raised correctly. as a companion and pet. Good. Okay. Come on, Chris. Uh-oh, Dennis ahead of you. It's one of those untrainable Airedales. Uh-oh. Looks like the circles won. I told you. I know, three Airedales. Well, one thing about it, we have a saying up there because we raise terriers. If you can train a terrier, you can train pretty much anything. And that's the truth. Okay. Now, all this is the fun stuff. We just watched a wonderful demonstration by the police for their dog. And it's very important. But the problem with it is, if you teach your dog to behave as that dog does, you have a lethal weapon. But a good dog should be able to protect you or at least back someone off. Now, just the look of Roxy, bring her out, Margo. Just the look of Emmett. Gus, you want to come out? The look of Jaeger and the look of Cash. Those dogs, by nature, they look protective. But I will guarantee you, any dog with teeth and toenails can be taught to use those as tools or weapons. The mouthful of teeth on these terriers is scary. The Australian Shepherds, they're bred to control cattle, 1,000 pounds worth of animal. We can't underestimate any dog. The bulldog, funny little dog. He's bred to fight with a bull tethered to a wall. When you don't teach these dogs manners, you have got weapons on the end of your lead. It can be in the form of jumping all over, playing too rough with your kids, to backing people off. Now, Petrea, why don't you guys step back? Thank you very much. Okay, Petrea. Now, we work these dogs. I don't like stupid dogs. I like a dog that's discriminating. I want a dog that if I go to a motel in the middle of the night, stop in, that dog right there tied to my belt loop would not let anyone come within personal space. So we want a dog that's discriminating enough that it knows when the person is friendly or when it's not by your command. So if I was a salesman that had been to Petrea's house and I come back at some weird time, this is what it should look like. Oh, where's... Oh, my hat's over there. Okay.
Come on.
Your dog doesn't look friendly like it did today.
Well, things are different.
Now, would I be silly enough to come forward? Oh, maybe not. I'll make an appointment. Now, that dog did nothing except stand there.
Jaeger, that's
it. Yes, it did. Now, when we're training, no, come back, Petrea. When we're training dogs for veterans, for anyone else who is physically challenged, emotionally challenged, one of the big problems with PTSD, any of those, is that you don't feel safe. The person lacks the security, they lack confidence, and they take on the wrong demeanor. That dog fills in those pieces. Okay, So if I come forward, now just stop. Okay, Atreya needs to be able to hand me, tell him he's okay.
Okay, you're fine. Good boy.
She gives him permission. Come on, dog. Come on, dog. Now, in this way, you have the choice. This dog doesn't just accept. He accepts if he's told to. On the other hand, all it takes is patrol. Okay, back up. All right, you're going to come forward and you're going to... No, not you back up. Me back up. Come forward. It's hard to talk on this microphone. All right, have him sit next to you. Now, I teach that dogs and the handler need to be a team. Like this, they are working together. So the dog shouldn't care whether I come up here. Dog's got no business asking for attention from a stranger. If this were a child and it came to a stranger, they would get a correction. My dogs do too. So if I shake Petraea's hand, he's just watching. Now the fact that she just told him to watch me, he's really watching. Now, if I'm afraid of dogs, Petraea can tell him to wait. Step forward, and he's watching her back. This is blocking. Nobody can come behind her to bother her. Oh, kind of like Mark and Kate over there. The dog sits at attention behind the person, and that prevents the person from having to worry about somebody coming up. On the other hand, if I'm a threat, she tells the dog to wait, steps behind. She's watching his back. If she tells him to wait or be easy. Now, if it really were a threatening situation, okay, praise him. Good boy. Okay, now you're going to come forward. You're not going to tell him to wait. You're going to tell him to be easy. Okay, come forward. Okay, now tell, easy. And you're going to say, watch him. Just be back up. Now, without anything, now, he knows me, so this is kind of, you know, but nonetheless, now, could he? Yes, he could.
Does he?
Only if the Treya doesn't use some common sense. Okay, tell him that's good.
Good boy, that's enough.
And when she says that's enough, the dog turns off. Now in the police, they can't have a dog that comes off that easy. They need a dog with drive. In a pet dog, you cannot afford to have a dog you can't call off. Now this is Jaeger's aggression toy. Okay.
Get it. Yeah, get it. Good boy.
Again, just like the police teach, it's a rough game.
Good boy. Jaeger, that's enough. Here. Good boy.
Oh, you mean it's not out of control?
Wait.
Absolutely not. That means Petraea needs to be able to stop that dog anywhere she wants to. Okay, you're going to stop him halfway.
Get it. Jaeger, that's enough. Enough. Back off. Back. Right now. Good boy. Here. Good job. Good boy.
Now drop him part way. I'll take the toy out of it. Come on, Jaeger.
Jaeger, go get her. Wait. Drop. You drop. All the way down.
Now a guard dog hesitates to go down in an aggressive situation. But he waits, and that's important. Now, that also would stop the dog from getting hit by a car. Okay, tell him to come out to me, and then tell him to wait.
Go get her. Go.
Come on, Jaeger.
That's far enough.
Ooh, yes.
Good boy. Good, far enough.
Now, this is tough for a dog, especially with this microphone. My commands are coming from over there, and it's really confusing.
Good boy.
Pull him back.
Jaeger, here.
doesn't get any better than that. I guess so. So when we start all the dogs with being a service dog in mind, we have got something special. Because as they get better, the tests become bigger. We start puppies about 10 weeks old. They're not expected to do all this, but we work on a path so that the eventual outcome is this.